question number fifth, first part. It's given f of x is equal to x square minus 25 upon x plus 5. X is not equal to minus 5. Here, x can't be equal to minus 5 because if I put here minus 5, it will come in indeterminate form. So, I can't put minus 5. Otherwise, all values I can put, all real numbers I can put. Only minus 5 I can't put. So, we have to write domain of a function is equal to real number minus only minus 5. You can't take minus 5. This is the domain of this function. So, right, let C be any real number. And C is not equal to minus 5. So, we write f of C will be what? You will write C square minus 25 upon C plus 5. C square minus 25 upon C plus 5. C square minus 25 will write C plus 5 into C minus 5 upon C plus 5. C plus 5, C plus 5 cancel C minus 5. This is f of C. Here f of C is coming C minus 5. Only C can't be equal to minus 5. Correct, C is not equal to minus 5. So you will find limit x tends to C. F of x will be limit x tends to C. Means x can't be x can't be minus 5. So x tends to C. Fx will be what? X square minus 25 upon x plus 5. Same, you will write limit x tends to C. X square minus 25. I will write x plus 5 into x minus 5 upon x plus 5. x plus 5 cancel out. Limit x tends to C, x minus 5. So, you will get C minus 5. And here also C is not equal to minus 5. Is it clear? So, you can see here limit x tends to C, fx, that is C minus 5. This is equal to this f of C. This and this both are what? Equal. So, you can say f is continuous, function is continuous at x is equal to C is not equal to minus 5. Only x is not continuous at minus 5. Apart from that, you can take any real number. So, you can say it is a continuous function. It is a continuous function. Like this, you have to solve. Limit x tends to C fx is equal to f of C. So, you can say f is continuous at x is equal to C when C is not equal to minus 5. Here also and here also. Now, question number 5th, second part. Number 5th, the second part, it is f of x is equal to 1 upon x minus 5. Here also I can't put x. Here I can't put x is equal to 5. So x is not equal to 5. Because if I put here 5, it will come 1 upon 0. That is undefined, infinite. So I can't take x is not equal to 5. X can't be equal to 5. So I'm writing x is not equal to 5. So you write domain of function is what? R minus 5. You can't take 5. Otherwise, apart from that, you can take all real numbers, r minus 5. So, let C be any real number and C is not equal to 5. You can't take 5. So, same you can find f of C will be what? 1 upon C minus 5 and you can write C is not equal to 5. Same limit x tends to C. F of x is equal to limit x tends to C. F of x is 1 upon x minus 5. 1 upon x minus 5, so you can write 1 upon C minus 5 when x tends to C. 1 upon x minus 5 is 1 upon C minus 5. Here also C is not equal to 5. So you can see f of C and limit x tends to C fx. Both are equal, so you can write limit x tends to C f of x is equal to f of C is equal to 1 upon C minus 5. So you can say function is continuous for all x belongs to real minus 5. Only you can't take 5. So f is continuous for all x belongs to real numbers minus 5. Only you can't take 5, otherwise you can take any real number. So you can say hence it is a continuous function. In its domain. Now question number 5 is over. Now question number 6. Question number 6, first part. Question number 6, first part. Fx is equal to, it's given sin 2x upon x if x is greater than 0 and 2 if x is less than equal to 0. So you know here, domain of function is what here? All real numbers less than equal to 0 and greater than 0. So all real numbers are included. So domain of function is equal to R. Start like this. We have to examine function for continuity at all real numbers. Let C be any real number. Three cases arise. Three cases will arise. First, when C is less than 1. When C is less than 0. Other case, C is greater than 0. And third case, C is equal to. So we will check on 3 points. Case number 1. If C is less than 0, then f of C will be what? Less than 0. So this one, f of C will be what? 2. Limit extends to C f of x is equal to limit extends to C. Fx is what? Here also you have to take 2 only because C is less than 0. So here it is equal to 2, you can see. So you can say function is continuous for all c less than 0. Now second case, if c is greater than 0, then f of c will be what? C greater than 0. So f of c will be what? Sin 2x upon x. So I will write sin 2c upon c. Now limit extends to c f of x will be what? Limit extends to c. C is greater than 0. So limit extends to C fx. This function only. So sin 2x upon x. So I will write sin 2c upon c. Here also sin 2c upon c. And here also sin 2c upon c. So you can write it is equal to f of c. So you can say this function is continuous for all c is greater than 0. We prove that this function is continuous for all real numbers less than 0. And function is continuous for all real numbers greater than 0. So, you have to check at point 0. X is equal to 0. Now, this is case number 3. Case number 3. If C is equal to 0, then F of 0 will be what? It's given to, I will write here. Now, limit x tends to 0, so 0 minus fx. So I can write limit h tends to 0 f of 0 minus h. Limit h tends to 0 f of 0 minus h. Definitely less than 0, 0 minus h. So I will write here function 2. So here it is 2. Limit x tends to 0 plus f of x is equal to limit h tends to 0 f of 0 plus h. 0 plus h means you are adding smaller quantity in 0. So it will be definitely greater than 0. So I will write here limit h tends to 0 sin 2 at the place of x I will write 0 plus h upon 0 plus h. So you can write limit h tends to 0 sin 2h upon h. Now you know one formula, when limit x tends to 0 sin x upon x is equal to what? 1. So here this 2h, here also I need 2h, so I will here write 2. So I will multiply here 2. This 2 will come out. So here it will be 2. Limit h tends to 0 sin 2h upon 2h. If h tends to 0, then 2h also tends to 0 sin 2h upon 2h. So this is 2. and this will come limit 2h tends to 0 sin 2h upon 2h is equal to 1. So 2 into 1 that is 2. So you can see here also 2, here also 2, here also 2. F of 0 is 2. Left hand limit is 2, right hand limit is 2. So you can say LHL is equal to RHL is equal to F of 0. So function is continuous at x is equal to 0. Function is continuous at x is equal to 0. So already we proved function was continuous for x is less than 0 also, x is greater than 0 also, and at x is equal to 0 also. So for all real numbers, this function is continuous. Is it clear? So what is domain of continuity here? All real numbers, same as domain of a function. So I can say this, for on combining all three cases, I can say this function is continuous in its domain, and domain of continuity is same as all real numbers. This was sixth, the first part. Now question number 6, the second part. Question number 6, second part. It's given fx is equal to x upon mod x. X upon mod x. X is not equal to 0. And 0 when x is equal to 0. So you can see this I can write, this function same I can write f of x will be, x is not equal to 0 means x can be less than 0 also and x can be greater than 0 also. So first I am writing for x is less than 0. Next I will write x is greater than 0, and third it's given x is equal to 0. This is same, x is equal to 0 it is given 0 only. When x is less than 0, then you know mod x will be what? Minus x. So this is x upon mod x will be what? Minus x. So x upon minus x will be what? Minus 1 if x is less than 0. And when x is greater than 0, then mod of x will be what? X only. So x upon x is equal to what? 1. So I can say f of x will be minus 1 when x is less than 0, 1 when x is greater than 0, and 0 when x is equal to 0. So you can see here, domain of function is what? All real numbers less than 0, greater than 0, and equal to 0. So domain of function is equal to R. So we have to find continuity of a function at all real numbers. So you can say three cases will arise. Let C be any real number. First you will write let C be any real number. Case number one. Case number one will be if C is less than 0. If C is less than 0, then f of C will be what? That's given minus 1. Now limit x tends to C, f of x is equal to limit x tends to c, f of x will be what? Minus 1 only. Because we are considering c is less than 0. So minus 1 is equal to what? F of c. So you can say f is continuous for all c is less than 0. For all c is less than 0, this is continuous. F of c minus 1, limit x tends to c, fx, this is also minus 1. So you can say it is equal to f of c. So f is continuous for all c is less than 0. Case number 2. If c is greater than 0, then f of c will be what? Greater than 0. So f of c is what? 1. And limit x tends to c, f of x is equal to limit x tends to c, f of x will be here 1 when c is greater than 0. So 1 to here 1 only is equal to f of limit x tends to c, fx is equal to what? F of c, here also 1, here also it's coming 1. So you can say function is continuous for all c is greater than 0. So we proved this function is continuous for all values, real numbers less than 0. It is continuous for all greater than 0, it is continuous. Now you have to check at point x is equal to 0. Now let's come at point x, c is equal to 0. So third case I will write is c is equal to 0. Third case you can write if c is equal to
0,
then f of 0 will be what? F of 0 is what? 0. Limit x tends to 0 minus fx will be what? Limit h tends to 0, f of 0 minus h. 0 minus h means definitely less than 0. So you can write limit h tends to 0, f of 0 minus h. So here it is what? Minus 1. So it is minus 1. Is it clear? It is minus 1 only. Now, limit x tends to 0 plus fx. I can write limit h tends to 0, f of 0 plus h. 0 plus h definitely greater than 0. So limit h tends to 0, f of 0 plus h, I will write here 1. Here it is 1. So you can see, here f of 0 is coming 0, here it is coming minus 1, and here it is coming 1. All are not equal. So you can write directly, LHL is not equal to RHL. Function is not continuous. All should be equal. Function is not continuous at x is equal to 0. It is continuous for all values less than 0. It is continuous for all values greater than 0. But at 0 it is not continuous. So domain of continuity will be what? Domain of continuity. All real numbers only 0 you have to exclude. So this is called domain of continuity. So function is continuous for all real numbers except 0. And domain of continuity is R minus 0. This was question number 6, second part. Now question number 7, first part. Question number 7, first part, you can see f of x is equal to x power 10 minus 1, x power 10 minus 1, if x is less than equal to 1, x is less than equal to 1, and x square if x is greater than 1. This is a function. So you will write same, domain of function is what? Less than equal to 1 and greater than 1. All domain of function is what? All real numbers. Start like this. Let's say be any real number. Let C be any real number. Three cases will arise. Case number 1, if C is less than 1, f of C will be what? C is less than 1, so f of C will be what? C power 10 minus 1. Is it clear? And limit x tends to C f of x when x C is what? Less than 1. So limit x tends to c, fx you will use this only, x power 10 minus 1. If you substitute c here, c power 10 minus 1. So you can see f of c and limit x tends to c fx. This is c power 10 minus 1. Both are equal, so I can write x is equal to what? F of c. So you can say function is continuous for all c is less than 1. This function is continuous for all c is less than 1. Second case I can write if c is greater than 1. If c is greater than 1, so f of c will be what? Greater than 1. So f of c will be what? F of x is x square, so f of c will be c square. And limit x tends to c, f of x is equal to limit x tends to c, f of x, same value you have to use, x square. So x square will be what? C square. So you can see here also it is c square, here also it is c square. So you can write f of c. It is equal to f of c when c is greater than 1. So you can say function is continuous for all c is greater than 1 also. So this function is continuous for all values less than 1, for all values greater than 1. Now you have to check at point 1 equal to 1. So now third case will be if c is equal to 1. Third case, if c is equal to 1, so f of 1 will be what? It's given f of 1 will be what? F of x is x power 10 minus 1. When x is equal to 1, so it will be what? 1 power 10 minus 1. 1 power 10, 1. 1 minus 1 is what? 0. Is it clear? Now, limit x tends to 1 minus f of x. I can write limit h tends to 0, f of 1 minus h. 1 minus h means less than 1, this function I have to use. So limit h tends to 0. At the place of x I will write 1 minus h power 10 minus 1. If I substitute here 0, 1 power 10 minus 1, here it will come 0. as you can see, f of 1 and limit x tends to 1 minus fx. Left hand limit and f of 1 is equal to f of 1. So you can say this function is continuous at x is equal to 1 from left. This is left continuous. This function is left continuous. I'm not saying this function is continuous at point x is equal to 1. I'm saying this f of 1 and this limit extends to 1 minus fx means f of 1 and left hand limit is equal. So you can say f is continuous at x is equal to 1 from left. Now limit x tends to 1 plus f of x will be limit h tends to 0. F of 1 plus h is equal to limit h tends to 0. F of 1 plus h, so definitely greater than 1, this function I have to use x square. So at the place of x, I will write 1 plus h whole square. If I put 0 here, h is 0 and 1 square is 1. As you can see, here you are getting 0, here you are getting 0, here you are getting 1. All three are not equal. So I can say, directly you can write left hand limit is not equal to right hand limit. So function is not continuous at x is equal to 1. It is left continuous because this and this is equal. So you can say this function is left continuous. But this function is not continuous at x is equal to 1 because all three are different. F of 1 is different. F of 1 and left hand limit is same, but left hand limit and right hand limit both are not equal. Left hand limit is 0 and right hand limit you are getting 1. So you can say function is discontinuous at point x is equal to 1. So domain of continuity of this function will be all real numbers, only you can take 1. So r minus 1. This is domain of continuity. Now question number 7, second part. Question number 7, second part. It's given fx is equal to 10x. F of x is equal to 10x. Domain is given here 0 to pi by 4. Value is given 0 to pi by 4. So directly here you can draw by graph. This is a graph I'm drawing first. It will be very easy. You can draw graph for 10x. This is 0. This is pi by 2. This is pi. This is 3 pi by 2. This is minus pi by 2. This is minus pi. This is minus 3 pi by 2. So you can draw graph from here. And write. This will be like this. And here I am drawing. It is like this. Same you can draw here also, minus pi by 2, like this. So you can see, domain of functions between 0 to pi by 4, means you can take values between 0 to pi by 4, 0 and pi by 4 also are also included. So see, here it is pi by 2, here it is 0. So in mid it will be pi by 4, 45 degree. So from here to here, if I am drawing graph, I am not lifting a pen. So you can say this is a continuous function, there is no break. So you can say from here to here, this function is what? Continuous. So fx is equal to 10x between x values between 0 to pi by 4, 0 and pi by 4 are included. So this function is continuous. Is it clear? Now 7th second is over. Question number 8, first part. Question number 8, first part. It's given fx is equal to 2x plus 3 if x is less than equal to 2 and 2x minus 3 if x is greater than 2. So you have to find domain of continuity. So this is given. Locate the points of discontinuity if any of the following functions. So if x is equal to this, so here you can write domain of function is what? All real numbers less than equal to 2 and greater than 2. So all real numbers are included. So you have to check this function's continuity at all real numbers. So I let c be any real number. Three cases will arise. Case number one. If c is less than 2, then f of c will be what? Less than 2 means 2c plus 3. So limit extends to c, f of x will be limit extends to c f x, you have to write 2x plus 3. So it is equal to c, then it is 2c plus 3. So it is equal to f of c. So you can say a function is continuous for all c is less than 2. Now for if c is greater than 2, then f of c will be 2c minus 3. So limit extends to c, f of x is equal to limit extends to c, f of x, which function we have used? This 2x minus 3, because c is greater than 2. So 2x minus 3 will be 2c minus 3. So you can see it is equal to f of c. So you can say f is continuous at for all c is greater than 2. For all c less than 2, this is continuous. For all c greater than 2. So all real numbers less than 2, this function is continuous. For all real numbers greater than 2, this function is continuous. Now you have to check it point 2. Third case will be if c is equal to 2, f of 2 will be what? F of 2 will be 2 into 2 plus 3, 2 into 2 plus 3, 2 to the 4, 4 plus 3, 7. 4 plus 3 is 7. Now, you have to find left hand limit and right hand limit. Limit x tends to 2 minus fx will be limit h tends to 0, f of 2 minus h. 2 minus h means definitely x is less than 2. This function I have to use 2 minus h. So definitely it is less than 2. So limit h tends to 0, 2 minus h. So 2 at the place of x, I am writing 2 minus h plus 3. If I substitute h 0, 2 into 2 minus 0. So 2 minus 0 is 2 only. 2 to the 4, 4 plus 3 is 7. Now say, you will write for right hand limit. Limit x tends to c, 2 plus fx. Limit x tends to 2 plus fx. So you can write limit h tends to 0, f of 2 plus h. So limit h tends to 0, f of 2 plus h. 2 plus h. You are adding h, smaller quantity, in 2. So definitely it is greater than 2. So this function I will use. 2 at the place of x, I will write 2 plus h minus 3. So h is 0. So 2 into 2 plus 0. 2 plus 0 is 2 only. 2 to the 4, 4 minus 3 is 1. So as you can see here, left hand limit and right hand limit, both are not equal. Left hand limit is coming 7. Right hand limit is coming 1. But you can see f of 2 is 7 and left hand limit is also 7. So I can say this function is left continuous, but left continuous at x is equal to 2. But here all three are not equal. Left hand limit and f of 2 is equal, both 7, 7. But right hand limit is 1. So I can say left hand limit is not equal to right hand limit. So function is discontinuous at x is equal to 2. But it is left continuous. 7 and 7. Left hand limit and this f of 2, both are equal. So I can say function is left continuous at x is equal to 2, or you can say function is continuous at x is equal to 2 from left. So here domain of continuity will be what? Domain of continuity. All real numbers you can take, only you can't take 2. 2 you have to exclude. This is the domain of continuity. This was question number 8, first part. Now question number 8, second part. Question number 8, second part. Fx is equal to x cube minus 3. F of x is equal to x cube minus 3 upon x cube minus 3 and if x is less than equal to 2, if x is less than equal to 2 and x square plus 1 if x is greater than 2. Fx is equal to x cube minus 3 if x is less than equal to 2 and if x is greater than 2, fx is equal to x square plus 1. So domain of function is what? All real numbers. Let C be any real number. Real number. Three cases will arise. Case number 1. When C is less than 2, f of C will be what? C is less than 2, so f of C will be what? C cube minus 3. And limit extends to C f of x will be limit extends to C. C is less than 2, so this function only. X cube minus 3. Limit extends to C, x cube minus 3. So C cube minus 3 is equal to f of C. You can see this is also C cube minus 3. This is also C cube minus 3. So it's equal to f of C. So you can say f is function is continuous for all C is less than 2. Now second case, when C is greater than 2, f of C will be greater than 2. F of C will be C square plus 1 and limit extends to C F of X will be limit extends to C F of X is X square plus 1, so C square plus 1. As you can see, this and this both are equal, so you can write it is equal to F of C, or you can say function is continuous for all C is greater than 2. So for all real numbers less than 2 it is continuous, for all real numbers greater than 2 this function is continuous. Now you have to check at point x is equal to 2. Third case, when c is equal to 2, f of 2 will be what? 2 cube minus 3. 2 cube minus 3. 2 cube means 8, 2 to the 4, 4 to the 8. 8 minus 3, that is 5. 8 minus 3 is 5. Now this is 5. Limit x tends to 2 minus fx, now left hand limit will be limit h tends to 0 f of 2 minus h. F of 2 minus h means less than 2, this function I have to use. So limit h tends to 0 f of 2 minus h is 2 minus h whole cube minus 3. If I substitute h 0 here, 2 cube, 2 minus 0, 2 only, 2 cube is 8, 8 minus 3 is 5. Then you can find limit x tends to 2 plus fx will be limit h tends to 0 f of 2 plus h. 2 plus h means greater than 0 function, greater than 2, x is greater than 2, 2 plus h. So this function I have to use x square plus 1. So at the place of x, I will write 2 plus h whole square plus 1. If I substitute h 0, 2 to the 2 square, 2 plus 0 whole square, that is 2 square, 2 square is what? 4, 4 plus 1 is 5. As you can see, here also 5, here also 5, here also 5. So you can say left hand limit is equal to right hand limit is equal to f of 2. So you can say function is continuous, x is equal to 2. So for all real numbers this function is continuous. So here domain of function and domain of continuity both are same. Domain of continuity both are same. For all real numbers it is continuous. Now question number 8 is over. Now rest of the questions I will do in next video. Thank you.